Derrick Gainer has been around a long time, and you're accustomed to seeing him on HBO on the undercards of Roy Jones fights, because like Jones, Gainer hails from Pensacola, Florida, longtime boyhood buddy of Jones, and Jones was for a long time his manager and effectively his promoter as he helped to guide Gainer's path upward in the featherweight division. But in recent years, Smoke found he was fighting less frequently and wasn't getting the fights that he wanted. So he's broken away from that mold, hired himself a new promoter, and hopes for new action. Already, it's been an interesting career. Let's take a look back at some of the steps along the way for Derrick Smoke Gainer. 5'9", southpaw featherweight. And he had two fights against the man you'll see later tonight, Kevin Kelly. The first of them took place in Jacksonville, Florida, on the undercard of the Roy Jones-Eric Luca fight. And this became a slugfest. As Gainer's confidence rose from round to round, he decided to trade and punch with Kelly and managed to knock Kevin Kelly down twice and to swell his right eye shut. But then Kelly starched Gainer with a solid left hand and scored a dramatic come-from-behind knockout. Gainer says it was the biggest lesson of his career, and Larry, when they fought for the second time in Madison Square Garden, Smoke was the one who had all the answers.
He was a more seasoned fighter fighting on that occasion, interestingly, on Kevin Kelly's territory. When he was at home, he got a little bit overexcited and left himself vulnerable.
Looking for a big fight, Gainer decided to go up 4 pounds to 130 and took on the most devastating puncher in that division, Diego Corrales. It turned out to be an unfortunate choice.
Yeah, Corrales was a big guy and a big puncher. Gainer had never felt anything like this kind of power and was just unable to deal with it.
So Gainer decided to come back to the 126-pound weight class and wait through the politics of the division to see if he could get a title shot. Eventually fought for a belt against Freddie Norwood, and in a dreadful, foul-filled affair, managed ultimately to subdue Norwood and score the knockout win that earned him his title belt. A strange knockout because Norwood was given an 18-second count.
It really was. And those two really deliberate fouls by Gainer in retaliation for what he felt he was on the receiving end of wound up winning him the title.
In one of his most recent fights, February 24 last year against Juan Perez Polo, Gainer moved, danced, and boxed his way to a victory, but did not look sharp, and he's only fought 4 rounds in the last 2 years. So he comes into the fight tonight without an enormous bulk of experience and activity to bring him into position to fight against an opponent over whom he is heavily favored. Larry Merchant, most titles, or most fighters who win titles and have a lot of fights on television, get recognition, get money and fame. Why hasn't that happened to Derrick Gainer?
Basically because he's a graduate of that Florida school of no-risk boxing. Safety first, second, and third, as Pensacola's Roy Jones has decreed. Roy Jones had the talent to make it work for him in the bigger weight divisions. In the smaller weight divisions, which American fans have never been fond of, it became a turnoff. Gainer now promises that he's going to do more fighting with his hands instead of his legs. And we'll give him a big hand if he does.
Well, we'll see. George Foreman, you know Derrick Gainer. Should he take more risks to be more entertaining, or is that too risky?
Well, taking risk is pretty risky, considering that most fighters at the end of the day comes out with a lot of bruises, little brains, and not much money. If he can get out of this business with a lot of money and use that height and reach that he has to keep him out of danger, I don't think he'll even find that much risk in his weight division.
Yeah, no, and for the category of having done good things outside the ring, Derrick Gainer founded a school for academically challenged children that has 150 students in Pensacola, Florida, and he maintains it to this day. So he's one of the good guys of our sport. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape now for Derrick Smoke Gainer against Oscar Leon. Gainer gives up a year in age. He's 30 to Leon 29. 3-inch height advantage for Gainer. 126 on the scale yesterday. 140 unofficially as he gets ready to come into the ring tonight. Leon, 126 on the scale yesterday. 136 tonight. Reach all the way across the back, fingertip to fingertip. Gainer with a 4-inch advantage. Arm length, which is from under the armpit to the edge of the outside end of the fist. Gainer with a 2.5-inch advantage. He should have the range to keep Leon away with his jab, if that's what he chooses to do. Harold Letterman, rules of the bout.
The Derrick Gainer Oscar Leon fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions. There is no 3-knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight. In case the cutter scores by an accidental headbutt, we go to the scorecards after the 4 rounds have been completed, and you cannot be saved at a bell in any round, including the 12th and final round. Jim!
All right, thank you, Harold. Oscar Leon has an interesting fight plan, to say the least. 90% of the time, you expect the smaller fighter to try to get inside his longer-armed opponent. Leon, giving up height and reach against Gainer, says, nevertheless, he intends to try to fight him from the outside.
And the dancing you see on the walk-in, presumably, will be the dancing we see in the fight-in.
Exceptionally strong physically for a fighter in this weight class, but it's not the quality he tries to bring to the fore in the ring. More of a boxer than a brawler.
A few words about Gainer. One is that to make weight, it looked like he had been eating air for about 3 days. You could see every bone in his face and in his and every sinew in his body. And the fact that he's added 14 pounds overnight, which is a tremendous amount for a featherweight, suggests that he had to go through a difficult time making weight.
Well, you look at his body and you assume already at 5'9", it's a problem to make 126. Then you figure in the 4 rounds of boxing in the last 23 months. Obviously, long stretches of inactivity produces a real challenge for Gainer. And it shows up in the fact that unofficially, he enters the ring weighing 140 tonight, from featherweight to junior welterweight.
Yeah, and also commenting on something George said before, of course he's absolutely right that fighters get hurt in this business, and it would be great if they could all retire with money and not suffer any damage. The question is the balance between the risk and the reward, and how much Gainer is willing to tilt toward more risk to get the rewards he hasn't been getting up to now.
All right, for our reward, the fight, let's go to ring announcer Michael Buffer for the official introductions.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, Forum Boxing is proud to present our co-featured bout of the evening, brought to you in association with the King of Bears Budweiser and HBO pay-per-view, along with DiBella Entertainment and Don King Productions. This contest is sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. The three judges scoring the bout at ringside are Silvestre Albianza, Carol Castellano, and Dwayne Ford. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Kenny Bayless. And now, ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of boxing. This is for the WBA Featherweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing yellow with blue and red, and officially weighing in at 126 pounds. His professional record, 24 victories, including 16 knockouts with only 2 defeats. Fighting out of Cartagena, Colombia, ladies and gentlemen, the challenger, the IBA world champion, Oscar El Artista León. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing red trimmed with white and officially weighing 126 pounds. His professional record, 38 victories, including 24 knockouts. He has 5 defeats and 1 no contest. born, raised, and fighting out of Pensacola, Florida, here is the reigning, defending, WBA featherweight champion of the world, Derrick Smoke Gainer.
Okay, fellas, both trunks are high. Any punch thrown in this area is going to be considered clean. Any punch thrown in this area is going to be considered clean. Now, gentlemen, we went over the rules in the dressing room. I want you to keep the fight clean at all times, protect yourself at all times, and what I say, you must obey. Good luck. Renaswate. Touch up.
Another Roy Jones protege fighter, Winky Wright, modified his boxing style to become more crowd-pleasing. Let's see if Smoke Gainer can pull it off and remain effective.
Gainer pointed out in response to that, incidentally, that Wright still hasn't gotten any big fights by altering his style.
Well, he's made $400,000 purses, far more than he's ever made before. And he's now being dangled out there as a possible opponent.
You know, Gainer's body is not all that wet with sweat, you see.
And Oscar Leon, perhaps sensing that Gainer is a little cold, comes in and goes at him and takes a shot. Southpaw against southpaw. This is exactly what Leon said, incidentally, that he wouldn't do. Backing Gainer up against the ropes and going inside.
That's what you want to do. You don't have a height advantage here. Keep that fight in close range. Hit this guy whenever you can. Maybe you're not going to hit him with shots on top until he drops his head a little more.
And George Foreman pointing out that Derrick Gainer does not necessarily look properly warmed up. Oscar Leon bringing the action to him in the first minute of round one.
Leon is fighting the right kind of fight. If he can go 12 rounds like this, he'd have him an easy victory tonight.
I wonder if Leon was sandbagging when he insisted to us and to everyone else who would listen that he would box Gainer from the outside.
That's the way you want to do it. Sandbag that. The people who ask questions, just give them some answers.
Don't tell him. I watched him two fights on tape, and he never fought this way in either of those fights.
You know, and he's not clutching, so the referee's got no reason to say let go because he's punching.
Oh, Kenny Bayless so far has done nothing, and Derrick Gainer slams a perfect left cross onto the chin of Oscar Leon, and Leon comes right through it.
And he also landed a pretty good right as he was backing up.
Right, sit back.
You got a guy with real thin legs like Gainer, and you can always win the pushing match. Just stay on top of him. Don't give him much room on the outside. And let him control you in the middle of the ring. Stay on top of him on the ropes.
Gainer has become increasingly proud of his punching power in recent years. Loves to describe himself as a puncher who can box. And given the way Leon started the fight, Gainer suddenly has adapted and says to himself, I'm going to go for a big knockout punch. Now Leon clocks him with a right hook and drives him into the ropes again. And finally, Kenny Bayless steps in as Gainer puts his hands on the back of Leon's head.
Leon is doing a good job. He just shouldn't allow Gainer that much room out to be away from him. Gainer playing the job of a puncher when he has all this boxing and reach advantage. Why do you want to play a puncher? Slugger.
I've often wondered if he thinks that he's going to become more of an attraction by saying he's a puncher.
If you're Gainer, you got to start using your right jab. Keep this guy out there. When you're not doing anything, keep flicking your jab. Keep the jab out there.
This is a tactic we've often seen Roy Jones use early in fights, looking for an opening with an uppercut.
A surprising round one as Oscar Leon came out and attacked Derrick Smoke Gainer. And as we go to Leon's corner where they speak Spanish, our interpreter is Ray Torres.
Listen to me carefully, champ. Take some air. Take a lot of air. Listen to me. You're going to go inside, move your body, and cut his ring off. Cut the ring off on him. You're going to work with the short punches.
Yeah. On the inside, you got to be more active, Michael. Okay, don't sit there waiting for one big shot. Just keep touching until you get off and up. Okay? All right.
In the inside.
All right. Don't move straight back.
All right, coach.
Okay?
All right.
You got me?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
All right, after weathering that early storm, You see that Gainer was looking to land one big shot and landed a couple that his opponent, Leon, took comfortably.
Big round for Leon. Gainer was 9 of 23 by CompuBox numbers. Leon, 14 out of 69. Gainer only threw two jabs in the round. So let's see if the fight changes in round two.
Now Leon is allowing Gainer to step around once he jabs. You want to cut the ring off to make him step in the direction you want. Cut it off me, cut off his movement.
Gainer almost got himself badly butted as he punched over the top of Leon, and Leon came up inside with his head.
You know, southpaws are no different from your conventional fighters. They don't like fighting southpaws either.
They'll all say they do. They'll all say, oh, it's better. No. My angles line up better against a southpaw. But you're right, they don't get to train against them that much.
Yeah, they don't. They're not comfortable with those guys who are on the wrong side.
But what they say is that they're not afraid of their feet and heads colliding when they fight another southpaw, but
they get the same thing as the conventional fighter because they put on the wrong side too for headbutting.
Derrick Gainer not very busy in this fight. Seems to be still looking here in round two to land one big shot. And Leon has gotten more cautious, perhaps as a result of the couple of big ones that Gainer landed down the stretch of round one.
Gainer's a harsh puncher, and he's allowed Leon to taste some of it, so he's not going to just jump in recklessly this time.
Leon is still the stalker, and Gainer wants to try to make him come to him. Now, as we begin to get more of what was expected to be the action in the fight, and this the crowd is not happy with.
And this must burn Gainer's ears because that booing is what he's been trying to turn around into cheers.
Good right hook inside by Oscar Leon. And Leon waving at Gainer saying, come to me. You come to me. Gainer says, no, I'm a counterpuncher. You come to me.
Everybody, you better realize if you're a gifted boxer, you don't let people boo and change you. You fight your style. Use what you got. Forget about what the critics say. They're not taking a shot. You're the only one in there that's got to hit, take those shots. Gainer's paid his dues. He's had to get up off the canvas.
He doesn't seem to be using his jab very much. He did there a nice jab to the body.
And there the jab set up the left cross, and he came inches away from busting Leon flush with the cross. But Leon lives to fight some more.
Time!
With your stick, Smokey. If you go counter, you gotta be in range. Don't push back with your jab. Okay? Mm-hmm. Let him run into your power. Your range ain't there yet.
I know.
Okay? Yeah. Your range ain't there. You gotta pick it up. Work your jab more and start feeling it. Close up a little bit so your big shots can land.
Okay?
You're pulling your feet out too much, man. Okay?
Mm-hmm. You gotta throw more punches. Be hungrier. Yeah, you're being too passive. Come on. Counter-punching, and then, you know, like I told you, on top of his guard. You gotta go on top of him.
Now Leon has to adapt to the punches he has felt to Gainer's style. Becoming a different kind of fight than it was in the first half of the first round.
We told you about Derrick Gainer's four rounds in 23 months. A lot of ring rust coming in. He's thrown 16 dabs in the first two rounds and landed only two. This is a guy who used to set up all of his action off the jab. Leon, 1 of 12 in jabs for the first two rounds. He's probably too short of arm and too far away to think of the jab as an effective weapon against Smoke. So now Leon just walks inside, and Gainer puts his hands on his head again and holds him down.
When a guy's got the reach on you and you start pecking you with those long shots, you have a tendency to duck first to get in, and then when you duck, you can't see where the guy is. So you are the referee. Next thing you know, you're hugging him.
Leon has extremely prominent veins in his temples, so it's hard to tell whether he's swelling or whether simply the veins stand out because that's the way he is. I think it's the latter at this moment.
Yeah, he's had some swelling already, but the corner man went to work on it real good.
Gainer is still throwing a majority of hard punches, not throwing a volume of punches.
Not really boxing.
He's got his man reaching for him now. That's what the boxer wants. You want your opponent reaching and swinging up at your head so that you can relax and get into your game. That's half.
Now Gainer jabs again and once again just misses Leon with the left cross. Leon now very wary of Gainer's left cross. Gainer gets in a little right as Leon comes in.
Step back.
Sooner or later, there's going to be a headbutt.
Gainer gets some distance and he moves his feet out of the way. His corner has told him, stop doing that. Want him to establish his position and keep it. Leon needs to go to the body a little bit so that Gainer can get a little lower. You're shorter, you don't have to reach. You got to throw those shots low to make your opponent calm down and protect his body. That hasn't happened with Leon yet.
And again, the chorus of boos.
And the boos are directed at Gainer, and while the boos probably shouldn't influence him in the fight, it helps Leon in the sense that it gives him the drama of the victory, of the fight. That he's making the fight, it appears. He's coming forward, and that can influence close rounds.
And the perhaps ring rusty Gainer looks a half step slow as we come to the bell at the end of round three. With Leon still motioning and saying, let's fight. Three rounds in the books. This the last preliminary bout before we show you the main event between Marco Antonio Barrera of Ciudad de Mexico and Kevin Kelly, the Flushing Flash, Flushing Queens, now living in Las Vegas. A gorgeous night along the strip as the pastel colors of sunset set in over Vegas. These scenes being brought to you from the Sanyo Blimp outside the MGM Grand. Inside, through the first three rounds, jabs. Gainer 2 out of 26, Leon 1 out of 25. In other words, it has been a fight, not a boxing match. And Oscar Leon helped to make it that way by running across the ring at the beginning of round one, stepping inside and clocking Gainer, and he's been trying to get there again ever since. Harold Letterman, how do you have it through three?
Okay, Jim, three interesting rounds. I've got a 2-1, 29-28. Oscar Leon. Jimmy, round one, Leon got inside just like he is right now. Smoke Gainer didn't do much. In the second round, Smoke Gainer at least landed some good shots, and Leon didn't do anything. In the third round, Leon was the aggressor, and Smoke didn't do anything. So 2-1, Leon.
Now they begin round four the way they began round one, standing in a phone booth with Leon trying to get at Gainer.
George, do you like the little man when they're fighting at these close quarters?
I like it then.
Come on, take him out, hit him hard.
The short opponent there is fighting the fight he should be fighting all along. He should have been fighting all along. Don't let this guy get to the middle of the ring where he can use his legs. Keep him there fighting. Don't let him hold. Don't you hold. Otherwise, the ref will tell you you break. Just keep throwing shots. That's what Leon is doing.
The interesting thing is that Leon looks comfortable doing what he's doing. He's fashioned his recent win streak. Five straight wins, mostly by fighting from the outside. He pot-shotted John Michael Johnson over the course of 12 rounds, but he's attacking Smoke Gainer chest to chest right now.
Yeah, you know, Gainer is landing some really heavy shots to the body. but they are harder to see. So they better do some serious damage for later on.
Because they aren't going to score like that left hand upstairs scored for Leon.
And Leon is doing a fight, and he's turning into a machine now. I like it. Keep it going like that. You want to wrestle the title away from a champion? Keep punching him. You just got to keep punching. Gainer is lazy now. He's taking a weak wrist. You get lazy like that, the other guy can beat you up.
This kind of fighting is a test of will. How long can you stay in the kitchen? Derrick Gainer gets in a big right hand. Leon keeps coming.
And I think it's good because he's making Gainer fight now. Something that Gainer didn't want to do. Now he has to fight.
Yeah, Gainer has landed a couple of real nice right hooks inside now.
Very good stuff. But it's harder for the long arm fighter to function in these situations.
That's right.
And Leon gets in another left.
He can only get one every now and then with the body. Oh, too long.
All right, fellas, watch your head, watch your head. Watch your
head. I actually think Leon has suffered more damage in this round, but at the same time, he may get the round because
of generalship
and aggression.
One man. Take some air, take some air, real strong. Deep breath. Raise your mouth. Look long. Don't give him any chance. One, two, and the uppercut. Okay, throw a lot of punches. When it's 10 seconds to go, open up. Open up.
You're missing a beautiful overhand left, man. You try to come back under with it. Go over the top with it, then come back under. Okay? Inactivity on the inside is not good. You listening to me? You go beat it, I want you to work it. Okay. You pivot one time out here, that's what I want you to do. When you glance shot to this guy's body.
Here's Leon, landing a left hand that you can see from the last row in the building. Short right by Gainer.
CompuBox numbers in round four credit Oscar Leon with having thrown 97 punches. He landed 24 out of 97. 25%. Gainer 18 out of 39 for 46%. You heard Larry's point. He thought Gainer landed the harder blows, but Alton Murkerson seemed clear on who he thought had won the round when he said to Gainer, inactivity on the inside is not good.
Leon is doing good. When you smile, get even shorter. A guy can't do anything to you when you get down low like that. Although he's clowning a little bit, but that exaggerates what he needs to do. Allow Gainer to get to the middle of the ring again, and that's when Gainer can throw those big long shots.
Leon's two losses were both by knockout to Julio Chacon and Daniel Seda. But he says he's become a stronger fighter since then, has a better, more relaxed, more disciplined life. And it seems to be showing up in the ring. Those two losses took place in 99 and 2000.
Derrick Gainer's doing nothing but waving his right hand down to his waist and back, looking for one big shot. And he's already hit him with his best, and it didn't do a whole lot. You've got to start building up your point system if you gain it. His punch is not going to get any harder.
Gainer has good power, but if you're moving backward all the time, it's hard to deliver it.
Not only that, Leon is taking him completely out of the boxing match now, throwing shots whenever he wants. Whenever he wants to stop and stop Gainer from thinking, he just run him into the ring, to the ropes, start throwing shots.
Derrick Gainer just not letting his hands go. Nothing's happening in there for him. Fifth round of a scheduled 12. Gainer seems to have decided that he's going to go for a knockout against the smaller, perhaps weaker Leon, but so far Leon is just mentally dominating the fight.
Doing a good job of throwing a lot of shots when he wants, and when he doesn't, stay out of the way.
This was a particularly inactive round for Gainer, a particularly easy round for Leon. How about the top featherweights in the division, Larry Merchant?
Here's a look at the elite fighters in this division. Barrera, who has had most of his career in America, is regarded in the U.S. as the champion. Many people in Mexico think that Eric Morales is a co-champion with Barrera at the minimum. Marquez recently won a belt, and there's Gainer. One thing, George, you mentioned earlier tonight that Barrera in fighting Kelly suggests that maybe he's not a champion. But it's been reported that one of Morales' recent opponents hadn't fought in 3 years and had lost his three previous fights. So I don't know how you can use only opponents as a measuring stick, but they did split their two fights, and there is a pretty good rationale to say they're co-equal champions.
I like that. Co-equal.
George, how big a factor do you think Gainer's recent inactivity is here? The only four rounds fought in the last 23 months. Is that part of what's showing up?
Gainer's got, he doesn't even know what he's doing. The strategy has disappeared. He wanted to punch early on. Now he doesn't want to punch. Can't start boxing. Once you stay out of the ring a lot, that's the way it is. That's what happened.
So it's harder to find your rhythm.
You don't know exactly what to do. And then you think of the guys going ahead and destroyed your plan before you get started.
It also seems that Gainer might have been overconfident because he does not seem to have any plan B now that Leon seems to be fighting a fight that has confused him a little bit.
Yeah, it seems to me he didn't even have plan A. Not listening to his corner at all.
And you might want to listen to Alton Merkerson, considering all the success Coach Merk has had as a trainer. Of course, you know, skeptics would say, well, he trains Roy Jones.
Good left
hand. Big right hand by Gainer that landed against Leon.
Good right hand for the change. He told him to go on top with that overhand left.
Well, Leon has been ducking Gainer's left cross. Now Gainer gets one in. And a right hand by Gainer, and Leon takes it pretty well, but this has become a good round for Smoke, who's landed three or four big shots in a row.
That's what his corner told him to do a couple of rounds earlier. Starting to follow some advice.
I think the key word for Gainer would be combinations. He's landed one punch at a time here and there. He hasn't put punches together.
If you're going to lose a fight and you're doing what your corner tells you to do, I like it. But when you're losing a fight, you're not doing what you want to do, nor are you listening to your corner. That's bad. Now he's starting to pick up the activity.
Leon reasserting himself with the right hand, leading with the hook. And again leading with the right hook. And Leon jumps in and busts Gainer with a looping left. So Gainer's minute and a half of aggression has prompted another minute of aggression from Leon.
The best two rounds that Gainer has had, including this one, have come when he has fought at a distance and stayed off the ropes.
The second round and the sixth. Practically no time on the ropes in this round after having spent almost all of the preceding round on the ropes, and there's a clash of heads, but they come out okay.
Time!
Okay, give me some ice. Hey, you're losing this fight, you know? You're losing it because you want it. You got to get serious. Come on, you're losing this fight. The guy doesn't want to fight you, so you got to do something else. You got to be more aggressive. Come on, this is a world championship fight. Let's go on it. Come on, this is your fight.
Hand jab or something to get you back in range. Okay. This guy's reading it. He's slipping out of range of it. Step up with another one, then hook off that one, okay? All right. Where we going, in the seventh round?
Seventh round.
All right, let's pick it up. Still ain't where I want you to be, baby. Okay?
Get that little smoke. Come on, baby.
Roy Jones just entered the building and has moved into ringside opposite us. It's perhaps a good thing that he missed the first half of the fight.
I think he decided to walk in so he could start pumping his fighter, his friend.
Harold, how do you have it through six?
Okay, Jim, 58-56. Four rounds to two, Oscar Leon. Jim, I'll tell you what Smoke Gainer is not doing. He's not snapping a right jab. I don't think he snapped a right jab all night. He's carrying that right jab down around his knee. And look at the clock, this guy with a straight left hand. When the fight is at long range, he gets it, like right there. But there was no right jab first. It's strictly a left hand lead. 4-2, mostly on effective aggressiveness for Leon.
Can't tell whether Gainer noticed the hubbub as Jones took his seat about five rows away from Gainer's corner. But those who know the relationship between the two fighters will surely attach significance to the fact that Roy is now here to cheer his man on.
A lot of Gainer's problems is happening because he's just won't let his fist go.
Ring rust.
Ring rush, you gotta fight a lot in that weight class. I mean, those shots and everything happens so quickly that you need to be in shape timing-wise.
Good straight right hand by Gainer as Leon overcommitted with his own right.
Now he has Leon thinking. That's when you gotta do something about it. You hit him with a good shot, you make him think, now do something. Gainer dances away.
So Leon gets away with having to defend himself one punch at a time, which is markedly easier than defending against sets of combinations.
All Gainer has to do is throw the old 1-2-3. He goes 1-2 and he stops. Throw three shots. That's when a guy decides, I'm not going to take a chance. I may get hit into that. And that being reluctant sometimes can cause you a fight.
This becomes a very difficult round to score in a fight that could go the distance. Neither man has really gotten much done here. So the last 30 seconds of the round become highly significant as one man or another might have a chance to steal it.
This is the Smoke Gainer that we
good body shot. That hurt. That was a good body shot.
Leon pointed to it as if to tell Kenny Bayless that was below the belt. Bayless just kept on moving.
Come on, 12.
And it was a scoring blow. Who knows? Maybe Gainer wins the round because of that body shot. Or that combination right there, more likely. Derrick Gainer ought to win that round because of the 1-2 he landed with less than 10 seconds to go. Speaking of 1-2 from the southpaw side, there are the shoes of Kevin Kelly. Perhaps almost presentable enough for him to wear them into the ring, and meanwhile they're working on the other side as well to try to achieve design perfection. Kelly shows us the well-wrapped right hand. Kevin Kelly, you'll remember him as the expert commentator for HBO's KO Nation boxing series. The man to arrive with the hip-hop jive to bring it to the show and keep it alive. Kevin says boxing commentary needs to be revolutionized. There are too many old guys doing it.
Not that, me. I'm not old.
No, he didn't mean you, George.
He means Larry.
He means me. There's a
no,
body
just
shot.
So happened we're in that end together, Larry.
End of the round.
Hey, Larry,
Gainer.
Don't they all? Eighth round of the schedule, 12. And Derrick Smoke Gainer probably helped himself in the seventh, landing 9 of 17 power shots. The 5 of 25 for Leon. That big combination in the last 10 seconds of the last round, one of Gainer's best moments in the fight. So now Leon seemed determined to come out and take this round to even the ledger again.
You see, it's strange about an audience. They start booing you when you don't do anything, and then you land a couple of shots, they start cheering for you. So if you're a good boxer, don't pay any attention to the crowd. Get out there and fight your fight.
on, Lee.
Stop. Get back clean, fellas. Come on, here we go. Step back.
And old George and Larry, we're not going to talk about
it. Well, there is an old saying that if you listen to the fans, you'll soon become one of them.
That's what happens.
Well, exactly. The fans pay your way in boxing, so you just can't ignore them.
No, you can't ignore them, but that's a dangerous square jungle there. No one can help you when the going gets tough in there. Now this guy's telling him, come on, you got to go out and do it yourself. Don't politic when the crowd start booing.
Pick it up. Work out. Watch your head. Pick it up. Back up, face up. Watch your head.
Big right hook for Leon. Another largely inactive round for Gainer.
When your man is on the ropes, you can't miss him. Even if you throw a wild shot, you're going to hit something. Just keep throwing punches.
You look at round one, you look at round five. Again, what's starting to happen here, it seems abundantly clear where Leona has his best chance to win the fight. Push Derrick up against the ropes.
It's no contest when he keeps him up against the rope.
Leon must have spent round after round in sparring, training to do this and determining that he would do it. If you looked at tapes of his fights, as Larry said, you wouldn't find this. Of course, you wouldn't find any 5'9" southpaw opponents either.
Ooh, a good
big body shot by Gainer. Leon comes back upstairs.
You hope you...
And down goes Leon on the body shot. Larry Merchant made the point that Gainer was hurting Leon with the body punches. And he got him there.
Seven.
I was just about to ask George whether you thought that Gainer sent something in there about his opponent that we don't.
Gainer is hurt now.
The knockdown is critical. The knockdown is critical because Leon was winning the round, and now Gainer will get a 10-8 round in what would otherwise have been 10-9 for Leon.
Listen to me. You don't know how to exchange punches. You gotta throw punches on top. Come on, let's work with him. Let's work with him. Cut the ring and work. Be careful with the knockdown.
This guy's gutsy. He can take a shot. As long as you can touch him, that's all I want you to do, okay? Give me some deep breath.
The body punch.
What are we going in? Nine. In the ninth round. You're looking good. You're shaving.
That put Leon down was a borderline punch, I thought, right there. But if you recollect, the referee said early in the night that both fighters had their trunks high.
And you have some pep underneath that too.
And Leon comes right back to his credit.
Kenny Bayless has been consistent about that belt line. Leon asked for low blows several times. Bayless didn't give them to him. So now Leon says, all right, I'll take matters into my own hands.
He could be leaving himself open for a giant shot here.
This is what you gotta do. A guy knocks you down, make him go back, mess up his antennas. He doesn't know what he's doing.
Now Leon's again telling Bayless, I'm getting hit low, and Bayless says, go back to fighting.
Now, Gainer's drawn some attention by Leon to the body. This is when you go back up to the head, when you go to the body and come back up.
Leon goes back to his office, driving Gainer into the ropes again.
Nothing but good things happen for Leon when he gets Gainer against the rope. He's out of harm's way. He can't get hit with the big shots.
Well, but he's gotten hit by those body shots occasionally in there. He's like, just like that and that.
And again, Leon asked Bayless to rule that it was a low blow. And again, Bayless says, keep on fighting. So by now, Leon should have the picture. If Gainer hits him on the red belt, it's going to be okay. Right on that red belt line, that's legal. And Leon better realize it.
Gainer is going back to looking at for that one shot again. That this is when he loses the round.
Victim of his own success. Whenever he achieves momentum in the fight, he begins.
That's that third punch. That's the third punch he should have been going with all night. One, two, and three.
Landed the right hook. Gainer swinging for the fences now.
Boy, when you throw those big, wide looping shots, it gets you tired. You got to stop for a moment to get the wind back. You almost need oxygen sometimes.
Good left hand by Leon.
That hurt Gainer that time.
Gainer's wobbled by that.
He should go for a knockout right now for Leon. Leon, go for the knockout.
He's trying. Gainer tries to counter back. I think that left hand hurt Gainer worse than any blow all night.
Yep.
Gainer countering with his own left and lands an uppercut. Leon takes a pretty good shot upstairs. He only went down on the body punch.
All right. Keep your handle down, Odin.
All right.
Look, get a little, stay a little calm on the inside now. And start punching, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, stay a little calm.
Hey, careful, be careful after the bell, Derrick. You hear me?
I can hear.
Be careful after the bell. You hear me, Derrick?
Okay.
All right.
Okay. That's how you win a championship. We're doing great. Take some air in. Take some air. Let's get some more air. You need some air.
Leon is fighting this fight like it's the most important thing in the world to him, which it is. An opportunity that won't often come to him. There you saw Roy Jones barking instructions at his friend and former protege, Derrick Smoke Gainer.
After the big windfall in the eighth round, when Gainer knocked Leon down to get a 10-8 round win and a round that otherwise would have gone to Leon for sure, in the ninth round, Gainer slowed down again. 13 out of 33 punches by copy box numbers. Leon, 17 out of 76. Harold, how do you have it coming to the 10?
I don't know, Jim. I'll tell you something. I think the shots Derrick Smoke Gainer has been landing in the last four rounds on a hard of telling shots. I've given him four rounds in a row, 86-84, five rounds to the four. Derrick Smoke Gainer. I just think he's coming on at the right time. I think he still has to use the right hand more to set up his left, but I think Smoke Gainer is taking charge of this fight.
Smoke Gainer has been coming on. I have it an even fight.
If Leon hadn't gone down in the eighth, he would still lead on the scorecard of Harold Lederman.
Well, that would be a 3-point swing.
That's it. That's the key to the fight right there. Leon's left eye is beginning to swell. They've done a good job in the corner.
Stop, stop, stop. Time. Time. Give me some time.
All right, Kenny Bayless wants to do a little housekeeping.
Yeah, it's getting a little slippery down there.
Either fighter benefit from the delay?
Oh, Derrick Gainer, of course, takes a deep breath, gets back into his rhythm.
Time in!
Gainer looks at that 1-2 shot. He ever gets it into a three rhythms.
Oh, another right hand shot by Gainer. Brilliant
three,
counter.
Four, five, six, seven. Okay.
And this was another round that Leon seemed to be winning up till that moment.
But as I said earlier, Jim, he's leaving himself wide open
yep.
now in his need to get into Gainer.
It's a counterpuncher fight now.
Yep.
Gainer is waiting until he gets almost to his face with that shot and throws his. That's what you call counter. Excellent timing.
Yeah, you seldom see a better example of the power counter than the punch that put Leon down in this round.
It was counterpunching at its best. Said it's not pretty to look at, but let me tell you, it's something.
And at the end of the day, that's what Smokes Gainer wanted from the fight, was to make Leon come to him so he could get those opportunities.
That extra shot Gainer is throwing now.
Making a big difference. Like you say, George, 1, 2, 3.
Good. Leon.
Right hand shot. Caught
Leon
Gainer.
Leon got in a good shot of his own.
Hurt Gainer, and once again, the knockdown is the key to the round. So now it would seem abundantly clear, Oscar Leon has to think knockout in the last two rounds. Derrick Gainer's put him down twice to add 4 vital points on the scorecard.
Four minutes.
Come on, let's get some air. Let's go real hard. We gotta fight him now. We gotta fight him.
All right. Gainer has been waiting all night for that shot. He took a little sidestep, almost like a bullfighter. He just stuck the right hand on him, and Leon was off balance, and the punch sent him the rest of the way.
Championship rounds. Derrick Smoke Gainer defending his featherweight title belt.
Right, here we go, time in.
Against out of the darkness Colombian challenger Carlos Leon. And Gainer, having knocked Leon down in both the 8th and 10th rounds, seems to have come from behind to take command of the fight.
Leon is really getting, he can knock this guy out. Gainer's been dropped in the last round of fights before. He can really come on if he won and pull this thing off big.
Big left hand for Leon. May not have enough pop to get it done.
I think he has enough pop. He just haven't been able to get Gainer close enough to the ropes when he lands those big shots. Gainer's hurt Leon enough to make him hesitate before he does something, and that's what you want if you're Gainer. Just a bit of hesitation.
So tell me, George, Jim, is this a different Smoke Gainer, or is this just a Smoke Gainer using his normal style and responding to this particular opponent?
Same old guy to me.
I totally agree. I think this is the Smoke Gainer we've been looking at for years. You know, maybe a little bit more dependent on power punching, but that's the trend he wanted to accentuate in his career anyway.
Yeah, I think that's it. He feels he's a puncher and he wants to use that more, but otherwise his style is unchanged. But even a little change can mean a lot.
Well, the fight has had its crowd-pleasing moments, although there have been moments of booing as well. And when you fall behind and come back to win the fight by knocking a guy down a couple of times, that's crowd pleasing in and of itself.
Stop the back clean, fellas. There you go. Watch your heads now.
Less than 4 minutes remaining in Leon's bid for the upset.
Leon was able to get in a nice shot that time. Counterpunches, by the way.
There's another good right hand counter by Gainer. And another one, well timed. Leon got in a right hook of his own.
That's right. I think Leon just need to be a little more dependent on his power, throw those hard shots and go for the finish rather than letting this guy bounce away. Gainer's getting away with murder out there. And he's committing it also.
Well, at the moment he dances away, Leon is fighting the style that's really most familiar to him. But it's not going to help him. Probably behind on points in this fight.
Let me have that ice bag. You gotta get serious. You gotta get serious. You gotta finish strong.
Put your hands right on there. There you go. Rest out. Give me some deep breath. This your last round. Hit and don't be hit.
Press gloves when you come out last and final round.
Right. Listen to me. When you touch gloves, you keep your hands up. You understand? I want you to touch and don't be touched this round.
We're losing the fight. The last round, we're way behind. If you don't fight, then we're losing the fight. If you don't.
It's your round, baby. You're taking this
round back. Swallow a little bit. Okay, start cleaning the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the 12th and final round.
Both fighters slowed down in round 11. Gainer only threw 28 punches. Leon only 49. Harold, how do you have it coming to the 12th?
Jim, 106, 101, 7 rounds to 4. Derrick Smoke Gainer. Jim, I gotta tell you something. Derrick Smoke Gainer, well, first of all, you gotta give him an extra point for the two knockdowns in rounds 8 and 10. Certainly, I think he won the last 6 rounds in a row. But, you know, it's awful tough on a judge when guys are fighting on the ropes like they are now and a judge is sitting on the opposite side. Because all you're looking at is the guy's back. So every so often, when you get a fight that's fought primarily on the ropes, it's murder on the decisions. I mean, you have to look for that. You can't see through a human being. If the fight's on the ropes, you can't see through the guy's back.
Thank you, Eugenia Williams.
Those body shots.
The photographer's getting your way too, Harold. Never mind.
Those body shots by Gainer, a lot of them were hit from the judges.
I have it a much closer fight than Harold does, but I don't think that Leon has done enough to take the title from Gainer, unless he does something very dramatic after this.
He caught Gainer with a left hand in there.
He's got him in a position. Now he has to just finish up his work. Leon is doing exactly what he's supposed to do, but he just stops and waits. It's not like you got 3 more rounds to do it. You got it all. Let it all hang out right now if you let Leon.
And incidentally, you may have heard Alton Merkerson asking Derrick Gainer to pivot when he's on the inside. If you saw the way he delivered those last two punches, that's the pivot. He steps to one side, throws the right, steps to the other side, throws the left, both from up and under, and there he does it again.
But he also told him to hit and don't be hit, and he's gone to the ropes in this round.
Yeah, Jim, the pivoting is done with your foot. One or the other, you decide. Like in basketball, one foot decides which is the pivot. If your right foot is your pivot, you move the left. And if your left is your pivot, you move the right. And he hasn't been pivoting, I can tell you that.
He hasn't?
No. It's like basketball. You know, you get your pivot.
Yep, I got you.
I think Gainer's losing this round big shot, big time.
I agree.
And I think it's a very close fight.
Watch the head. Come on, here we go.
I think the difference in the fight is going to be the two knockdowns.
Well, it's hard to lose a fight in which you've had two knockdowns.
That's right.
I mean, if there are no other 10-8 rounds, well, all you'd have to do is win 2 or 3 other rounds.
That's right, which he's probably done. And most of the fight has been fought in Leon's style, but Gainer has taken advantage of his opportunities in some instances. So we'll see. A fight which was booed on occasion during the absence of action winds up providing enough action that the crowd applauds and
that's
sometimes
right.
They're standing.
I think there was more action in this fight than 2 or 3 of Gainer's fights that I've seen combined.
He had no choice to put some action into it now. This guy, Leon, was walking right through it.
Brave effort. Harold, how do you have it at the end of the fight?
Okay, Jim. Without question, I thought Derrick Smoke Gainer was a little bit tired in round 12. Oscar Leon was all over him on the inside, punching away. He did win round 12, no question. It's about time he went around. I thought he lost something like 6 in a row. So 115, 111, 7 rounds to 5. Derrick Smoke Gainer should retain the title. Give him an extra point for the knockdowns in round 8 and 10.
That's what the best judge in the world says.
Well, certainly the best known. The judges who will matter here are Silvestre Abainza of the Philippines, haven't seen him before, Carol Castellano of Nevada, and Dwayne Ford of Nevada. So two veteran Vegas judges and the judge from the Philippines who is not familiar to us. They'll be the ones who determine the winner.
Put it on the floor.
Difficult fight to judge, I tell you that.
Got some adrenaline down.
Let's go to Michael Buffer and find out who won it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecards. Carol Castellano scores the bout 114 to 112. She has it for Leon. Dwayne Ford scores it 114 to 112 for Gainer. And Silvestre Abianza scores it 117 to 110 for the winner by split decision and still WBA featherweight champion of the world, Derrick Smoke Gainer.
Broad disparity in scores. One of the three judges had it 114-112 for Leon. And then the deciding vote was 117-110 for Gainer. Gives you an idea of how opinions can differ. CompuBox numbers finding both fighters landing a total of 135 punches, 134 for Gainer. Leon throwing almost twice as many and therefore connecting at about half the rate. Power shots, really where the story lies, because neither fighter relied on the jab with any regularity whatsoever. There, Gainer 118 out of 259, but by far the harder and more effective blows. Leon 128 out of 583, that 583 power punch number, showing the degree to which Leon pressured Gainer, dictated the pace of the bout, and made the fight, really.
It was a good fight. You know, the crowd was looking at a boxer and a real true brawler together, and you got it like a beauty contest. Now, which did the judges decide is prettier?
And we talked about how the ring rust might have affected Gainer coming in, George, with four rounds in the last 24 months. Now he's had a good 12 rounds under
his. That's right, and he needs to fight a little more often, though, if he's going to be more effective at that boxing style. Using the pivot, stepping from side to side. You need action to do that. The gym just will not get it for you.
All right, let's see what he has to say about his effort with Larry Merchant.
Thank you, Jim. Congratulations, Derrick. You were softening him up early in the fight with body blows, but did you feel that you were being, in some sense, out-hustled and that he was catching the eye of the fans and the judges?
First of all, thank God, the insurance do I do. No, I wanted to let him wear himself down. I noticed on the tapes, he threw a lot of punches earlier than he wear himself down. But yes, he was throwing a lot of punches and he was trying very hard. You know, he came at me a little bit more than I really wanted him to. But, you know, we got the victory.
And the knockdowns were the difference?
I thought I still won the fight without the knockdowns. I mean, he was throwing punches, but knockdowns, yes, of course, they secured the deal.
All right, let's take a look at least one of the knockdowns here on the monitor, and you tell us what happened here, Derrick.
He was throwing punches on the inside, and I threw a hook at his head and came under with a left body shot. I knew he would be relaxed on the inside because I wasn't throwing a whole lot of shots in there. I was really letting him punch himself out. And that knockdown, that was a check hook. You know, I checked him coming in. I knew he was coming. He was going to be coming big at me.
It
so
looks like he just sidestepped him and swiped him.
It's what we call a check hook. Thank you, Perfect 10 Magazine.
Were you feeling rusty early in the fight, or was it his awkward style that made it difficult for you to get your timing?
You know, my time was there. I mean, I haven't fought in 8 months, but I'm not gonna blame that, say that's the reason, but the guy came in, he was fighting hard, and he got a different style. I mean, he fights more defensive than he does offensive. So it's kind of hard. You know, he throw punches and he back up. So I had to take my time to get him.
Thank you very much, and again, congratulations.
In the house.
Roy, you came in here in the sixth round. Were you late or were you watching it somewhere else?
I'm running late, got lost trying to get here. You know, this is a long run out this way, so I was like, how do I get there? And they sixth the room also, it's all good, but. And I was here, I got it when he needed me, you know?
Well, you didn't miss much in the first half of the fight because because Leon was ahead on all the scorecards right at that point. So
our thing was to let Leon come out and jump ahead. We didn't know he was a fast front fighter. Let him go ahead and get his stuff out the way. Let him bear himself down. And I told John to stay poised. Use the jab, fan him, make him come in late rounds, you'll get him. And that's how I dropped him twice, and that's basically what we want to fight for.
You've talked to him, and Derrick, you've talked about fighting more with your hands than your legs. Did you feel you did that tonight?
I think he fought more with his hands tonight. He used his legs a little bit more than I wanted to see him at the end, but it was smart because Leon was a dangerous puncher still. And as a matter of fact, as Smoke dropped him, he came in and caused Smoke with some good shots. So it was smart not to exchange if you don't have to. But he did start sitting down and throwing more punches when Leon came, which is what I look forward to.
Okay, Roy, let me ask you about yourself now. You've been stripped of two light heavyweight titles. There may be another one.
We still have the WBA champ, so it don't really matter.
Are you going to be satisfied just to stay as a heavyweight now?
You know what, Larry? It's very difficult for me to really answer that question right now. But the way things are looking, like I told him, people like, well, Mike Tyson, I told him, you know, I ain't interested in fighting Michael unless it's $100 million. But if it's $100 million, me and Mike going to fight. There ain't nothing to talk about. Right now they're saying Evander. I say, you know, Evander's a pretty good cause too, but I don't care. I deal with whoever. So whatever they bring my way, I'm going to be ready for it. I don't care who it is, heavyweight, light heavyweight, whoever offers me the most change for the champ to put it on, it's going
okay,
down.
You know that there's the most change in the heavyweight division, and everybody seems to be saying that the developments point to a fight with Holyfield in the fall. So you're saying there's nothing official, nothing decided, but if it happens and everybody can get together, that's something that would be satisfying to you.
It'll be very satisfying to me. I am the WBA heavyweight champ of the world, willing to defend mine to the end. So whatever comes my way, if something good comes to get me to fight a certain opponent, bam, it's happening. I'm not making no commitments right now because nothing big has come my way that has really grabbed my attention and said, this is what we're going to do. But when something does, that's what we're going to do.
Thank you very much,
Roy. I don't know who that be. Game's
that's
move.
What we're going to do. All right, back to you, Jim.